As the famous Hindi song goes, Ajeeb Dasta Hai, Kahan Shuru, Kahan Khatam. I think life is just like that, filled with ups and downs. We never know what's next. And that's why we believe someone who dares to dream, certainly his dreams do come to reality. And after all, you're here and I'm here. What more? Dreams do come true. I am Reena Dsouza. And you're watching The Reena Dsouza Show. Co-partnered with Grey Nichols. In association with Chasing Perfection Events Private Limited, The Naked Eye Motion Pictures, Radio Indigo 91.9 FM. Location partners, Fandom Gillies Kormangla. Talent management partners, Games Unlimited. NGO partner, Trinity Care Foundation. Gifting partner, Live Active, Nissa from Riches Laboratories. Usiru Shock Green. Cab partners, Royal Tours and Travels. Social media partners, Pickstar Media. Makeup and hair, Manjunath. Wardrobe partners, Yukba. This story is very special to me. He's a young chap who's born in Kerala. He then moves to Hyderabad and then to pursue his passion for cricket, moves to Bengaluru. Whole of his 18 years has all about playing cricket in summer holidays. But now he's someone who's known to represent India for the under-19 national cricket team. Please welcome young and charming Devdutt Padikkal. Hi Dev, welcome to the show. Thank you so much for taking time out and joining us. Please take your seat. Can I see those smile a little more? You know, you got that cute smile there. Wow. So, under 19 national team, so you've been playing now. So, we know that, you know, the first ever selection took place under 14. You played for the state team. And I've heard that you're very, very passionate about cricket and you've been very focused about it. Tell me more about it.
You know, my life has been only about cricket from the time I was born, to be honest. Like, when I was maybe 6-7 years old, I started playing cricket. And maybe at that time it was just as a hobby, just time pass for fun. But then as it went on, it became a profession for me. I took to it very seriously and hopefully I'll make it big in cricket.
Wow. You are someone who even plotted your school. You know which school you wanted to go and you went to the school, the St. Joseph's, we all know, right? We've got the cricketing legends there. So tell me more about this. How did you know and, you know, what was your research you wanted to go there?
Yeah, once I shifted to Bangalore from Hyderabad, the first thing I did was actually go to a cricket camp, even before school. So, first I went there and I spoke to the coaches and all that. So, they told me these schools are nice, they support cricket. So, it was an obvious choice for me. Joseph's, there were two options maybe, actually it was Joseph's or Cotton's. I don't know, I just felt a connection with Joseph's and I decided to join there.
Wonderful. So, you know, you give me a confused look here. Should I tell you Sugamano or should I tell you Namaskaram, Namskara or should I tell you Ella Unarundi? What do I talk
actually,
to you?
Actually, you can use any South Indian language. I know pretty much everything. So,
okay.
I understand all the South Indian language, maybe except Konkani or something.
Yeah, I can teach you. I'm here for you.
Yeah, probably even that, I'll get to that.
All right. So, you know, I have some cue for you here. Do you know this famous Hindi song? Chand sa roshan chahara, sulfo mein rang sunehra. So, we've got some secret element here. So, we've got some secret arrival of a guest. Can you guess who that would be?
My mom or something.
Your mom?
Yeah.
Did you tell your mom you're coming for the shoot?
Yeah, I did.
Did you have to take a permission?
No, not actually. I had to, but
you had to.
Yeah.
Did obviously. They say yes?
Yeah.
Thank you to your parents. Yeah. You know, oh, look who's there. You get a seat.
Hello.
Hi, Chandni. Thank you so much for joining us.
Please
take your seat. So you know, Chansa Roshan
Chahara. Sister.
That's your lovely sister out there. Yes. So you know, the whole reason of you being on the show is to bring out those secrets.
Happily.
Yeah. I know Devdutt has been dating about 10-15 girls so far. You know, he's got a spicy life. He loves painting. He goes skydiving.
Do you?
I wish. I seriously wish.
Okay. So you know, I know this exciting story. And that exciting story is in age of 9, right? 9 years old, you did not board a vehicle and you went back home. People thought you were missing for a few hours.
Yeah.
What's the story about?
Yeah, so basically I was, I just finished my practice in the academy. It was like 15 minutes away from my house. So usually my driver comes and picks me up from there. or my dad or someone comes. So I was waiting at the place as usual. I was just waiting, and it was evening, I think around 5:30 or 6 or something. So no one arrived, so no one came to pick me up. So I was like, maybe they are busy or something. So I called them up, but still no one responded. So I was like, they've forgotten me or something, like I exist or no. So then I started walking, because I didn't find anyone for like half an hour. And I didn't think too much that time, I was a kid. So I just started walking. And as I started walking, I got scared because I'm alone and I didn't know what to do, if I'm lost.
But you, even though you didn't know the way, you wanted to discover
it,
isn't it?
Yeah, so I started crying. So people are staring at me, I'm walking through the road and people are staring at me, I'm crying.
Is this guy who's been kidnapped and running
around? Yeah, what's wrong with this kid and all that? So then when I finally reached home, my parents are like, where the hell were you? Like, I came walking.
Oh my God, what's your take on that, Chandni? How was it?
Imagine like having your brother missing and your parents are just freaking out inside the house. God. Like they don't have no clue. And at that point in time, I was also young. I'm like just 4 years elder to him. So even I was young. So I thought, oh my God, it's something really bad, because my idea of kidnapping is someone getting kidnapped in a movie and like not ever coming back.
Oh my God.
So even I was really scared for him. But yeah, when he came back, I think it was a huge relief to just know that he was just walking back home. It was such a huge relief.
See, she really likes you. She really loves you. I think it's part of the support there. So okay, tell me more about Dave. You know, tell me some secrets about him.
Secrets about
some
Dave.
Some deep hidden secret.
I wish I knew that, like, because I have tried to pry it out of him myself.
Oh, God.
He's such an introvert at home. It's very difficult to get information out of him, no matter what it's related to.
Does he snore louder or,
No, nothing.
You're like that nice boy. Come on, I like it.
The nice kid.
You're a nice kid.
Yeah.
Okay. So tell me more about when we say cricket, right? At a young age, you've started playing. So you certainly have some inspiration that you look up to, saying, you know, I want to play along with them. Who would that be?
Like when I started watching cricket, like my dad used to watch. So I used to just sit with him and watch cricket. And initially I saw Sachin Tendulkar, Rahul Dravid, and that golden generation of cricketers. And then as I moved, my inspiration as in batting as such was Gautam Gambhir. I used to love his batting. Whenever I used to get time, I used to watch his videos. And so he's been one person who I've looked up to a lot.
Wow. So I hope you play along soon. Yeah. However, hopefully. I've got one more, you know, gift for you. You know, we've been told that you're very special to us. So how about we get some more people on our show? What do you say about that?
Sure. Why not?
Yeah. Who do you think they should be? Just give me a cue on that.
Maybe a girlfriend for me, who set me up with or something.
Yeah, we just had that offline conversation, right? So yeah, I want to.
What's up?
Hello, welcome to the show. Thank you so much. So you'll have to just adjust for a moment in the couch. Yeah, thank you. So all that you'll have to do now for me is, yeah, if it's true, you show me thumbs up. If it's false, you just do this for us. Yeah, we've got this quickly.
I'm also included in this game.
Chandni is going to be mute for some time. All right. So he says he's not dated anyone. Is that true? Have you guys dated anyone? He's confused. He's not very sure if he's dating or something. Let's keep it there. Okay. Okay. Since he's not dated anyone, tell me, does he at least talk to girls in college?
Girls come and talk to him
is what you're saying. Dave, look at that. So you guys have to really show me the thumbs up there, huh? Yeah, if girls come and talk to you. Dave, you have got so many, man. Come on, you can't be doing that.
No time. I don't get time. Seriously, I don't get time. I'm hardly in Bangalore.
Right. Yeah, we get that, no problem. Dave, next time when you become really, really big, just write a check for my show. All right. So, Chandni, this is a question to you. Yeah.
Yeah.
Since Dave has been, a very studious kind of guy towards cricket, is that right?
Yeah.
Or you've been also a good kid even when studying.
Academically, he's extremely good. Actually, surprisingly.
Academically, he's also good.
Yep. It's very
tell
annoying.
Me what's bad about Dave.
About him.
Good question.
Okay. Bad about him. I think again, I have to say that it's very difficult to get a hold of him. Like just have that sister brothers bonding session where you just go out, because he's always traveling, or he'll be like, no, I'll just sit at home, I'll play FIFA, or I'll just go out with my friends. So that's the bad thing about him. Otherwise, he's a jolly good kid.
Okay. How many times does he play FIFA? Is that 2, 4, 5, 6, 7?
Yeah, keep adding.
Keep adding. All right. However, so we've got two amazing people. So they've shared a lot with us. But I've also been told that you've got to join somewhere else shortly. So you're here on a short brief. So before you leave, this is something I want both of you to do for Dev. Yeah, just find a girl for him as quick as possible.
I've told them.
Yeah? Yeah?
Even they're useless. They won't. They haven't been able to so far.
Use less. That's right. We get it. Don't worry about it. However, you know, we want something all of you to do. Yeah, we want you to show your teeth for us because a camera person is just waiting for a nice picture before all of you leave. You know, two of you leave here.
Right.
So let's pose together. Yeah, as nicely as possible. So I'm going to be like that. You know, the nice queen sort of look. And however, you guys keep smiling. So here's our picture. Right there is the camera. Let's smile for it. So we know, you know, cricket experience had started very early in life with you, right? So how did you start? How did it all began? With what?
Yeah, so it began actually when my dad got me a plastic bat, to be honest.
Wow.
Yeah, it was just a small bat. Actually, I have it, still have it with me. So whenever I get time and when I'm in my house not doing nothing, I just take that plastic bat, throw a sponge ball on the wall and just start hitting. So that's then it actually started.
It was 9 years old, even when he was, I think, 3 or 4 years old, he had an extremely tiny bat. I think it was this big. Mm-hmm. He's just taking it around, like swinging it around the place, just hitting random balls on the floor. I think since he was a child, my dad knew that he loved cricket because that was his choice of toy everywhere he went.
Wow.
And so since then, he's always gotten a birthday cake also, like a cricket pitch or like a ball and a bat. And I still remember seeing those cakes because we always have it in the album. And we see that, yeah, this is since he was a kid that we always had that cricket thing around the family.
So that also says parents have been very supportive,
yeah,
very isn't
extremely,
it?
Yeah.
So you told me that dad used to come and watch every match when you were younger. Tell me more about it.
Used to come for all the matches. In fact, sometimes I used to be like, don't come. What if I don't perform and all that? Because I used to feel bad when he doesn't, when I don't do well in front of him. So he used to come. Still, he made sure that he was there for all the games whenever he could come, and he used to support me. Like, he used to take videos of me, like, when I get 100 or something like that. And he's been really great in that way, you know. He's been really supportive in cricket for me.
So this is the element that is the game segment presented by Gray Nickels. And we have with us Devdutt Padikkal. So Devdutt, are you ready to play with us?
Yeah.
So Chandni, you're going to help him out, huh? Yeah? Okay. So I'll give you a number from 1 to 3. Choose a number.
2.
2 it is.
Yeah.
So all that you have to do is you'll have to pick that ball, yeah? And you'll have to balance the ball. You start from the right side, yes. Balance the ball with the wooden board, yes, hold it. And pass the ball from one to next wooden cart and so on. It should flow into the bottom, yeah? You get 3 chances to do it. Are you ready?
Yeah.
And I'll give you a countdown for it, yeah? Okay? And your time starts in 3, 2, 1. Go for it. You get 30 seconds to...
No.
let's do it again, Chandni,
yeah.
Isn't it?
Yeah.
What do you say? He can do it? So okay. Shall we give the countdown? Here we go. 3, 2, 1, go! That was in the end, never mind. So we do this again. So you've got the ball again. This is your 3rd chance. Yeah. So you've also got penalties. So we'll tell you what the penalty is. Okay, let's go for it. 3, 2, 1, go for it. You need to balance the ball. However, you missed it twice.
Yeah.
So you've got a penalty to pay. Yeah? The penalty, how about this? I ask you a question, you answer to me. Yeah? Tell me, what is that secret that nobody else knows at home but just you?
I told my parents that I just fell down because I didn't want to tell that I was in a bike with another friend. So I just told them I fell down while I was running or something like that.
So that's all you did?
Yeah.
Never mind. We
that's the only thing.
So it's time to play the next game, and the next game is exclusively by Gray Nickels again. So let's go for it then. So Dev, I hope you're ready. You know what you need to do. You know, pick up your favorite bat there, right? That's one. So we've got maybe your favorite bowler here. We've got Chandni with us. Chandni, you need to bowl to Dev there. Yeah? So... there we go.
Careful.
And you get 3 chances. Yeah, ensure that you don't hit it very hard and the ball comes
I'll
to me. Avoid all
for
that.
You. Don't worry, it's okay.
Here we go. Woo! Let's go for it.
Woo! Oh.
Oh, that was good. Yeah, you looks like you've trained her.
Looks like she has to start playing now.
Oh, that's nice. So you've got one last chance. This is going to be the one last chance. Okay, Chandni, the third one. Woo-hoo! Fantastic. Thank you so much, David. It was lovely having both of you. Chandni, it was wonderful to have you with us too. However, we've got something more. We want your signatures on our bat right here. He's got this lovely signature. Why do you want him to change?
I didn't know. Because I was not home for 2 months. I think he changed at that time.
That's why you didn't know.
That's why.
Ah, but this is cute.
It's kind of cute. Yeah, I like it.
So I think that is amazing team up there. Because we've got a brother, we've got a sister, so we've got each other's supporters. However, this is all about the Reena Dsouza Show. That's wonderful. So I have been told that there was a time in your span of where you've played so far that you were not given a batting opportunity. Can you tell me more about it?
Yeah, so I think I was in one of the junior nets when I had first come to Bangalore. So I was just another kid in the camp. Like there are nearly 1,000 kids who come there. So I was just another kid, and that time the coach thought I was a bowler. And he never used to give me batting in the nets and all that. So the first few days, okay, I said, I'll get it someday he'll give me batting. I was like, okay. But then after a week or so, he's still not giving me batting. So I got pissed off. I started crying. I went to my mom, like, Mom, they're not giving me batting. So then my mom called up
like
the coach.
Like that typical, you know, school story.
Yeah, clearly. So my mom called up the coach, Nazir sir, who's been my coach throughout now.
Okay.
So my mom called him up and he spoke to the coach, and then I started getting batting. And from there, they got to know that I have some potential, actually.
Wonderful. I think Nasiruddin is a great coach. So, you know, even he shared some views with us, and we would like to bring that on as well. So, please take a look what Nasiruddin shares about his views on Devdutt.
Devdutt was 11 years old when he came to KIOC. Then I started coaching him. I saw Devdutt, the strength in Devdutt was his focus and passion towards the game. I think our aim, ultimate goal was to play for the India under 19 team. He has achieved that, and he has improved himself as a valuable all-rounder. I think in next 5 years, I feel Devdutt will be an opener in the senior national team. I like to wish Devdutt all the best for his cricketing future. Go, Dev. Go achieve your goal, ultimate goal. All the best, Dev.
You know, we all have those strong pointers, those weak pointers. We all know it, right? So you've spoken about Coach Nasiruddin, and he's also spoken about you. But we would like to know, is there something that you regret in your life so far?
You know, biggest regret would be perhaps not winning the Katonin Shield. You know, for me, that is a prestigious tournament for school cricket, especially. So, like, we got to the finals, we got that far, and even the previous year, I couldn't win it. So this year, it was really important to me to make sure that I do something for the school and win it for them. So the fact that we got till the finals, and then in the end, because of me, we couldn't win it. So I felt really bad at that moment, and like everyone was crying and all that. It was really sad that day, but that helped me, you know, to accept failure and just to move forward. And there are certain things that don't go in your favor at times, and it's important that you just go over it and succeed, to be honest.
So you combated that. How did he deal with it, Chandni?
I was surprised that he dealt with it so well, because I remember there was a huge crowd for this tournament, and it was at night, and there were like lights and everything was going on, and there was a huge uproar about this tournament at that point in time. I felt really bad when he got out, and I was screaming at him from the benches, because like, how did you get out? You should have scored and won this game. When he came back, I felt bad for him, because you know, there was a lot on his shoulder even at that time. So I was actually very proud of him, because he got over it and he's done really well in life.
I think under 19 national cricket team, that says it all. So we all are proud of him.
Very proud.
So today, when you guys may be going out for a shopping or so, are there some crazy fans who bump in and say, I need picture, sir?
Not to that extent, but there have been few instances when people have asked me for pictures, and it's new to me, and I don't know what to think about it. You know, I'm like, what am I supposed to do? Should I be naive.
All that you have to be is like you stand tall, smile, and smile as much as you can.
Yeah,
look at them.
That's
smile.
All I've been doing so far.
So have you given autographs so far to anybody?
Yeah, a few.
I've been trying to get him to change his autograph because I'm like, please make it look better. But he has not been listening to me, and I'm like, just practice some better autographs so that, you know. Because you're going to be famous and you're supposed, like, it'll be there everywhere. So at least make it look good.
That's nice.
It's not something that I've gotten through yet.
My autograph is right. Yeah. All right. So when we speak about autograph, she says you're not changing it. Why? What's the reason?
There's nothing like that. I'm just too lazy to think about autograph.
You are too lazy.
Yeah.
Should I take it? You are focused, you're dedicated.
Yeah, but then that's only in cricket. And rest of the things, I'm very lazy. I don't like going out. I'm just always at home and just
You're just
chilling.
Like me. Just that I'm lazy all the time. You know? That's the only difference. Never mind. However, has any girl come to you and told that you've got a pretty smile?
Not face to face yet. But there have been messages and all that. But
blind messages.
Yeah.
Wow, that's nice. Okay, so now we are getting into our next segment, which is again very, very special to us. Here we have young cricketers like you or young aspirants who are looking forward to get that one opportunity to be a cricketer, right? So this is called as an educative segment, and we have with us today Devdutt Padikkal. So Devdutt, tell us, what would be your suggestion to those aspiring cricketers who maybe are under 14 or under 9 years of old, who are preparing themselves already? So what's your suggestion there?
So far, there's only one thing I've learned as a cricketer, that is, never forget why you started the game. Basically, that's the most important thing. You started the game because of the love for it, the sheer passion that you had for the game, and you didn't think about selection or fame or money or anything like that. You started because you just love the game and you wanted to play, you wanted to go out there every day and just play the game. So that's the only thing I would like to say to all the aspiring kids, to be honest. Just love the game, enjoy what you do, and rest everything will follow.
Okay, that's great. So you have to enjoy what you do.
Yeah.
That's also a very important part, is what you're saying. Okay, so have you come across some young kids who are asking for mentorship with you?
Yeah, there have been quite a few actually in past 3-4 days. Everyone, whenever I go to my academy and I go to practice, they come up to me, they ask me if this is correct, if this is correct, if am I doing this right. So I keep telling them, I'm not the coach, you should rather go and ask a coach, because I, to some extent, okay, I can tell them this is my, because okay, but other than that, I can't really make them the
do
cricketer.
Everything,
yeah,
isn't it?
Yeah.
You're also learning along what you believe in, which is a very, very good factor.
Yeah.
Now I have a very serious question, you know. You've got a nice hairstyle. Are you planning to change it?
Not really. It's been like that for years now.
Are you going to do like Devdutt Padikkal, DP? That's me.
I don't think he'll be allowed inside the house by my grandmother if he gets that.
Oh my god, how about tattoo? If he was tattooed, what would happen then?
I actually don't know how my family's tattoos.
Oh
but
my
I don't think
god.
Anyone would be happy. And I think he's even interested in getting one.
Wow.
I don't like tattoos.
You don't like tattoos at all? Just write somewhere Reena Dsouza picture. I don't mind, you know. I would love it. We'll hide it later.
Sure.
All right. So we've been talking so much. Aren't you a little hungry? You know, it's getting a little longer.
Yeah.
Yeah. How about having some dish together? Are you ready?
Sure.
You like it? You like having food?
Any day.
Good food? Yeah, good cuisines?
Yeah.
How about that? So we are here in Fandom Gilly's Kormangla. So let's see what's got on the dish. Like what's the chef made for us. So yes, let's get the chef special, please. So I think we are ready to eat some food, isn't it? So the yummy food is en route from Fandom Gilly's Kormangla. So there it is. Here it comes. Okay. Wow. Okay. Gilly's chili chicken. And Gilly's chicken lollipop.
That's really yum.
This is really good. I think we really had some amazing food today, isn't it? Did you love the food?
Yes, absolutely loved it.
Energized, isn't it? I love those dimples. They're shown a little more
it's
now after eating
food.
It's all because of the food. So if you need dimples, come to Gilly's.
Yes, absolutely.
I like that. So with that, we now move to the next segment, which is again very important segment, and that is the rapid fire round. So here goes your first question, Devdutt. Your question is, if you could be a Hollywood actor or actress, who would you be and why?
Probably Ryan Gosling.
An actress?
Actress, oh, it's a tough one. Angelina Jolie.
Next question to you. If you could be a Bollywood actor, who would you be?
Hrithik Roshan.
Hrithik Roshan? Alright, next one.
Can't dance like.
Okay, who was the last person you texted?
Last person I texted? I think my mother.
Your favourite month of the year?
July.
Why?
Birthday. Birth.
So if you could be someone else for an entire year, who would you prefer to be?
Right now, probably Virat Kohli.
So we've got one more question to you.
Yeah.
And that is, do you like being organized or being messy?
Organized.
Being organized. How about you, being organized or messy?
I want to be organized, but I have a feeling I'm a little messy.
I like it that you're like me, somewhere.
I know.
We are same. Okay. So what would you choose? Being handsome or being rich?
Oh, rich.
How about you, being beautiful or being rich?
I think if you're saying beautiful from inside, then I would say beautiful from inside rather than rich. Smart answer.
You mean from inside?
Yes, from inside.
So we take some herbal products.
Yes, absolutely.
All right. Okay. So, which job you do very horrible at? You're very horrible at.
Which job? Talking to people.
So, five things you would change about yourself that you wanted to or you want to.
That's why I would like to talk more.
Okay.
Other than that, smile more, definitely. Uh-huh. Other than that, there's nothing much, you know.
How about you? What would you like to change?
About myself?
Yes.
Actually, start being a little less lazy.
Okay.
Make sure that I'm more organized.
Okay.
And start being more active, not just academically, but also physically around, like exercise more. I think that's about it.
So before turning 30, what are the five things that you want to do?
Represent India, obviously, that's one goal. Secondly, maybe go on a world trip. Find a girl, obviously.
I can help you. 30 minutes away, you know.
Yeah. Yeah. And
two more to go.
Perhaps get something big for my parents. Really good gift or something like that.
Okay.
And other than that, nothing much.
Okay. How about you? What would you like to change, or what would you like to adopt before 30?
Well, establish myself as a really good lawyer, a successful lawyer. Mm-hmm. Manage him. Be his agent. I intend to do that once he gets to the major leagues.
That's nice.
Then, again, like have a world tour, see a lot of beautiful places. That's always, I think that's there in everybody's list.
Okay.
Then try multiple cuisines,
mm-hmm.
as much as possible before I turn 30 itself.
Okay.
I think that's about it.
So both of you, we're wishing you good luck. So Devdutt, especially we want to see you where you want to be, right? And Law Madam, that's
you.
All we want. All right, I hope both of you had a good time with us.
Very
you?
Much, yeah.
Yes.
So in our show, you know, we don't let people just go away, you know, just like that. We have something more. So we give away gifts as well.
Right.
So we've got some amazing gifts that both of you would like. So here's the gift hamper for you. So here's our hamper. So hamper's all ready. So we've got our gifting partners today. We've got Live Active, who are someone who makes herbal products. They've got various products. We've got toothpaste, we've got shampoo, we've got conditioners and whatnot. We've got Nesa from Richards Laboratories. Their laboratories are located in Bangalore and they are into herbal products as well. So we've also got Usiru, who are into making ceramic pots and planting seeds. So yeah, we've got a kit here for you, for both of you here. Please take it.
Thank you.
And I hope both of you use our products and tell us how do you like the products. Yes. So keep smiling, enjoy the show. Thank you so much for being on the show. I can see those beautiful smiles on the faces. Just tell me one thing. Yeah? Did you like the Reena Dsouza show?
Absolutely loved it.
Do you like Reena Dsouza?
Absolutely.
All right, thank you so much. So thanks a lot for being on the show. We really loved and having both of you on the show. And this is the Reena Dsouza show, the show which brings out the untold stories that you haven't heard before.